We are in Torre Pellice, in the Waldensian Valleys. We are at the Waldensian Cultural Centre, the former Valdese boarding school. Around us are the valleys. Behind me is the Waldensian House, the seat of the Waldensian Synod, the annual assembly. Next to the Waldensian College, symbol of their belief in education and lives in this region. Around me are the mountains where it grew and still grows. This is the history of the movement and the Waldensian Church today. 8 centuries of battles, of struggles, but also a search for freedom and, in the end, how they obtained their freedom. Founded in 1170, after the conversion of Peter Waldo, a merchant from Lyon, the Waldensian movement went into hiding for about 3 centuries to avoid persecution by the Catholic Church. In 1532, it encountered the Protestant Reformation in a genuine meeting. The Waldensian barbers, Waldensian preachers, went to meet the great European reformers and the Reformed. The Waldensian Church was born. The movement became the Waldensian Church. Its members began to practice openly and started to build their own temples. The message of the Protestant Reformation was present and spread through the Waldensian valleys using the book they translated, the first French Protestant Bible. In 1685, with the revocation of the Edict of Nantes by Louis XIV, King of France, the lives of thousands and thousands of Protestants in Europe would change. So too did the lives of the Waldensians. In 1686, they suffered at the hands of the Duke of Savoy, whose repressive edicts forced them to abandon their lands, or we should say, they were imprisoned after weeks of raids before being deported, in the true sense of the word, to Geneva. Here, the Waldensians organized themselves, and with help from the House of Orange, opponents to the King of France and the Duchy of Savoy, they succeeded in returning to the Waldensian valleys, in what is now known as the Glorious Repatriation. They reached the valleys of Val Pellice, Val Chisone, and Val Germanasca, where they fought to reconquer them. They would fight for 9 months, and only at the end of a long, arduous siege did they manage to escape death and resettle on those that had once been their lands. After this period of harsh repression and the great wars of the 1600s and early 1700s, a long period of reconstruction began in the Waldensian valleys of Val Chisone, Val Germanasca and Val Pellice.
Warfare
had left crisis and famine in its wake. Now a long period of reconstruction began, which involved rebuilding not only the social fabric of the region, but also houses and crops, everything that the territory could give, but no longer gave, to ensure the survival of the population. This process of rebuilding also included viticulture in the lower reaches of Val Pellice and Val Germanasca, and halfway up Val Pellice and Val Germanasca, and to a limited extent in Val Chisone. On the 17th of February, 1848, Carlo Alberto's royal decrees changed the lives of the Waldensians. Now they were citizens. They were part of the kingdom in every respect. One thing did not change. The question of religious affairs remained the same. The question of being different from the others continued. But the Waldensians could go to the kingdom. What would become the Kingdom of Italy? They were now part of the movement that would contribute to building the nation. Today, the Waldensian Church is based in Torre Pellice and in Rome. It is perfectly integrated into the Italian state. Since 1984, there has been an agreement between the Waldensian Church and the Italian state. The Waldensians are recognized as citizens and can practice their religion freely.